1974 79 GMC radio. This is actually one that's made by Motorola to fit these vehicles. Which this one here is pretty neat. It has a built-in fader, and right underneath sticking out is a little tongue right there, and that's actually a built-in balance, which is cool. It's AM and FM, and we've done a full Aurora Design conversion on it. It now has, of course, AM, FM. It has four channels out, 45 watts a channel, stereo. Has pre-outs on it if you want to add a sub or an amp to a set of a rear speakers. Has a auxiliary in, which is automatic. I'll be demonstrating that for you in this little new deal right here. USB port. This is your harness you'll be getting. It charges your phone and plays a thumb drive that comes with it, with the video on it and some music. The files are built on it for you. Had to get my right thumb drive. Whoop. Well, now we got a glare. Let me see if I can get rid of that glare. We got a little bit of one, maybe not. There we go. Got rid of part of it. Let's go down a little more. There we go. Now, got rid of the glare. Now you can see it. It's got AM, FM stereo, auxiliary, and USB. This will charge your phone, your devices, play a thumb drive that you'll be getting with it, with a video on it, some music. Manuals on there, even though I give you a paper copy. If you was to lose them, you can go back and find them on here. We've done a complete cleaning. Now, I had another radio just like the one he sent in with a better face on it, and that's this radio here. His had been splattered with some kind of black paint. And you wind up taking a lot of stuff off of it to get that paint off. So we switched it over. This is the same identical radio. It does have the, it's kind of deluxe model, has the built-in balance where his didn't. We've cleaned it all up, polished the knobs the best that we can. And normally I would change these out, but they are a split shaft instead of a D shaft. I'm still looking to see if I've got a set of split shaft ones. Anyhow, USB port. Push button operated, which is cool. I'll demonstrate all that for you. Bluetooth, hand-free phone calls, voice command, voice assistance. Radio will scan your stations for you, and got voice ID, which is real neat. Right now you're on FM, according to your slider bar. Of course, you get to keep everything working. Flip it over AM, AM radio. You notice the little light changed. That's your operating LED. FM, we got all your push buttons working. Preset, so you preset your stations. Built-in fader, front one, rear, front, balance it out, balance, right side, left side. Balance it out, so now you ain't got to worry about anything on that. Treble and bass like you've always had. Now the first thing we'll do is show you how to put this radio in the scanning mode. In case you're going down the road, you can put it in the scanning mode, let it find a station for you. So all you got to do is take your tuning knob and turn the needle up twice. One, two.
Scanning for stations.
Now it's going to start scanning for stations. The needle's not going to move. I'm going to show you how to lock on a station, how to even find that station in case you want to preset it, and how to identify it. You might be looking for a ball game or something. You know the station you need to be on, but you can't find it. I'm going to show you how you can get closer to that or even locate it.
And to break the power of money over our lives, we should have a spending plan. The Bible talks about that the ant stole.
And what that ramification would be.
Still scanning up the scale.
To put that on your child to make that decision at 8 years.
Say you like that station there, all you gotta do is turn this once to lock on it.
Station hold.
She'll lock on it.
Or the new Air One.
It'll go quiet till you find it. There it is. Pull out a preset. Preset it. You got it. Now you'd like to identify it. It'll do this on AM and FM. Take this little push button. You can hide these anywhere you want to underneath a dash. I've been putting them in cigarette lighters because a lot of people don't smoke anymore. But if you do smoke, you might want to put it somewhere else. Want to know what station that is? Press it once.
FM
89.5. It'll do it on AM and FM. That's pretty neat. Alright. Now I'm going to show you Auxiliary In. My phone's a little bit difficult to do, but a lot of people have new phones that do not have headphone out jacks, which is Auxiliary In jacks for the radio. Even though you got Bluetooth, you might want, somebody might get in your car. This little deal you can find on eBay, or you can go to your local phone store. They've got them. And what it does, it plugs into your charging point port. Can't even talk. And it gives you an auxiliary out and an additional charging port. So all you got to do is just plug this in. If I can get it in there, plug it in. Pull out your mail-to-mail cord, which comes in the package. Might have that stashed in your glove box or your console. Plug it in. And then now you're set up for auxiliary in. Bring your phone up. Let's go to music. And let's hit play. Now you notice the little light's gone to green there. It means you're on an auxiliary in device. Well, somebody might get in there and want you to hear something. All you gotta do is pull it out and plug it in. You got it. Anytime you want to go back to radio, all you got to do is take that device, and by device I meant satellite radio, CD changers, XM radio, anything that's got a head that puts out a signal, you can plug it into your auxiliary in and use it. Turn that off. In 20 seconds, the radio, if you don't touch it, will automatically switch back over. If you want to cancel that 20 seconds down shorter, just turn it off and right back on.
By wood and wire from the next waltz.
That's how your auxiliary in works.
Won't be long.
I demonstrate that because a lot of people tell me they don't have auxiliary out ports on their phone. Well, now they've got a device you can pick up for very little. I think about $7 I get for that.
Gifted young singer-songwriter and musical historian Sam Anadon. And we'll hear the story of a couple mentoring and feeding the needy.
Alrighty.
Come join us for E-Town, Sunday nights at 9 p.m. on Roots Radio WMOT.
Now we're going to pair a phone up. Let's go to Bluetooth on my phone. We're going to do the initial pair up. There's two ways to do it. I can turn this up twice and pair it up. Or I can hold this push button down like this.
Phillips Recording Studio in Memphis.
Bluetooth ready to pair.
Showed up on my phone. All I gotta do is tap on. She'll tell me when it's done.
Traveling is number 4 2 weeks in a row. Drive by truckers. Rosemary with a Bible and a gun on the list.
As strong as the day was long. Sometimes my phone don't like to do it. Cause I just deleted a bunch off of it.
Ashtray, it would fill up twice. The windows down felt nice. As miles stressed the twilight of the day. Driving up by 55, Mississippi zooming by. Salvation in the cool November air. I'm searching for the mixture that could paint a pretty picture of the wind.
I just got rid of a bunch of them on my phone, so. did connect. I cut it off at the wrong time. All right, let's try that one more time. We'll see if she picks it up. I've already paired it up. I shut it off right before she come on and told me it was paired up. It's on there. Let's turn it on.
Bluetooth connected.
It already picked it up. All right, now you're paired up. And that was one of the tests I was going to do, was shut it off and make sure when you turn it on, it found your phone. So you shouldn't have paired up but once. It will take multiple devices. It'll always pick the very first one. So if you're the one who wants to answer all the phone calls, that's the one you want to do first. Now we're going to do a voice command. You get two mics, one that you can run extendable. Might be a convertible. I don't know if this is a Blazer or what. It might be a convertible or it might be loud. You might want to get the mic closer to you, but you also have a built-in mic right here. There's a little bit hole you can't hardly see, and it's got a built-in mic. We're going to check it out. Now, I can't bring my phone up by holding this down again. Let's do it with the volume knob. Let's go up twice. Play music. Now, it's designed so you do not have to pick this phone up and have it in your hand while you're driving. Of course, they're handing out big old tickets for that nowadays. So you can put this thing anywhere and operate it all from this right here. So you can actually, two ways of advancing your music or backing up. Press this once to advance. Twice to back up or repeat. Or I can do it right here. Turn it.
Am I wrong?
Back up. Back up even further. I can even do it with a push button as long as that needle moves. Alrighty. Now let's do a voice command. Let's go back to radio. Now if a phone call comes in, it'll override anything the radio's doing. She'll come on and say incoming call. All you do is turn this up one click to answer the call or press this once to answer. When you're done, you can let it hang up on its own. It'll go back doing whatever you had it doing. Or if you want to end the call twice here, turn back down one click. It'll end your call. Let's go back to radio. Stop music. Put it in pause, right back to radio. That's how your Bluetooth works. And see if we want to do that test one more time and you turn it off. That way when you get every time you get in the car and you do your initial pair up on your phone, it will find it.
Bluetooth connected.
USB port, you'll get one of these, video on it, music on it. Plug it in, go straight to it. A lot of people like to hide these things. Same way, advancing music. Once, up, twice, back, repeat. Up, up, back. Now, a lot of people like hide these on time. You got to take us out if you want to charge something or change the thumb drive. A lot of people buy extra thumb drives, build a file, and put whole albums on them and label them, which is pretty cool. You can put multiple files on this one. There's two ways to put it in pause so you don't have it so you can't get to that from where you're driving. Two ways. Hold this down 1 second. Pause. Right back to radio. It's going to cycle right back around. And then I'm going to show you how to do it with the volume knob. That way you really don't have to push the push button. Bring it back up 1 second. Right back to it. Depends on how long it's down, whether it goes back the same song or not, how long you put it in pause. We went up for Bluetooth here. Let's go down. One, two. Pause. Right back to radio. You can do it. Down motion on your volume knob, and to go back to it, you can do it. Right back on radio, down, right back to it. good sound on a little radio, cleaned up nice, and ready to go. I appreciate you letting me do it for you. Thank you.